Champions Gillingham were afforded a respectful welcome by a Burton Albion side looking forward to their first ever appearance in the Football League playoffs. The pleasantries didn't last long. After 9 minutes, Bradley Dack was brought down by Aaron Webster and Miles Weston calmly gave the Kent club the lead. And after that, it was action all the way. As the storm clouds passed, the sun shone on Burton, especially Billy Key, gobbling up the second chance after Jimmy Phillips rattled the post. Phillips deserved more as he made it a testing day for Marlon Romeo, one of six Gills players who made their league debuts. The midfielder's second assist helping Michael Symes get on the score sheet. An impressive turnaround by Albion, who were heading for fourth place, the highest finish in their history. Phillips' trickery catching the eye again before Calvin Zola made the advantage more comfortable. But Martin Allen could still unleash what he calls the weapon. Thankfully, that's just teenager Sam Muggleton's massive throw, which fellow debutant Nathan Niafli powered home as the leaders' young side went down fighting, much to their manager's delight. While they're on the sunbeds, Burton will do battle with Bradford in the playoffs. And Zola and co will surely need to be at their most clinical against Phil Parkinson's cup specialists.
Well, it was Burton's highest ever league finish, but what about those outside the top six or even the top seven?
I think Paul Tisdale will be disappointed at Exeter that they fell away a little bit near the end. Chesterfield made a late run, you know, so there's nobody outside there that really should have been in it.
We'll finish tonight by saying well done to the only one of our teams who earned the right to be called 2012-2013 champions. Good night.
Long ball over the top, good ball from Gregory. Kempwell inside the area, shoots, goes in, goal! Danny Kempwell! That's it! Gills are promoted!
It's been my dream all my life since I was a little kid. It's just a dream come true. The moments we can dream
on. The goals have been set. Number one, there was obviously the promotion. It's been a fantastic achievement by all the players, all the staff, and the backing of the chairman. We've got a few games now to try and finish it. The sun says we can cry over, put troubles on the moon. But more than all these miracles above, good people, we got love. The players have shown right through the year they deserve to be the champions.
They're proved beyond doubt they are the best team in League Two this season. They are champions.
We've made some history. It's a great feeling. I'm very, very proud of all the players. I'm very, very happy for all the supporters. To be the champions is unbelievable.